Like,
you don't have to pay bills.
No, you don't pay bills. No.
You don't have to pay bills. If you're good, you get money.
Some people come out of jail with more money than they even went to jail. That's the truth.
Everyone beat their dad. Understand? Harry, there was one guy with me, Harry. He was loving it there.
Yeah. So, guys, love going back.
Bro, yeah.
Love going back to
you. He said to me, he said, bro, we don't have to pay. I'm going to pay. I'm going to come back in.
look, I've been speaking to you. See, they can give sentences, yeah? That there's a new law, I think it's called EPP. It's an extended license. Sorry. Yeah. You know what it is, bro? You need more mentors in the streets. You need more people that can intervene. Yeah. You need communities to come together.
Yeah, that's what we're doing, inshallah.
Look how much the youth centres have closed down.
Yeah, the mosques need to take part in this.
You know, in my area, London Schools, yeah? There was so much youth centres in Hackney, Tower Hamlets. Yeah. When you're at a youth centre, they will do residentials, you go on trips, like you stay there, like you won't like feel the need to go out in the streets. When they close all this down, these kids are bored.
Why are they closing it down?
Austerity. This Conservative government, they've closed it all down. Then you've got kids that are bored, yeah? Then now imagine your parents, let's say you grew up in an orphanage or you grew up in care, your father's not there, or your mother's on drugs, and then you've got no money, and then you're on Instagram and social media,
I want this, I want that,
you go do some naughty stuff, and then you know what it brings, isn't it? People say music has a role to play.
It does have a role to play.
You guys are falling behind as well when it comes to the mosques. What we need to do is
and the masjid as well.
Yeah. Sometimes it's a bit. Especially the brother. So what we do, brother Abu Aisha, this brother has two football teams. MashaAllah, monitor. He's one full and one white bush. So MashaAllah, he's bringing it all together, and I told him we have to get involved. We have to, because we try, alhamdulillah, we've been doing even classes, invite them. But we have to understand, we have to tell people, those who don't want to be in the gang anymore, come speak to us. We are happy because some of them are saying, I need that lifestyle. When I want to go back home, yeah, I used to think, I need to get out of this lifestyle, man, it's too much. You understand? But you have no one around you to help you.
There's no counselors within the mosques either.
Yes, but when you have a brother out there offering help, look, if you want to get out of that lifestyle, you want to someone come forward. We are here, we should help you. You want to do that. Especially people like me, like you, who live that life, I'm saying, and left that life, would be good for people to speak to. Because why? They can relate.
They can relate to it. Yeah.
I mean, you know, sometimes, for example, if I get pissed off around where I live or whatever, if I don't want to speak to my boys and tell them what my problem is, I'd rather go to a mosque that's open for hours extra.
Yeah.
Then I can speak to, you know what, Shamsi Akhi, I've got this little problem.
Yeah.
Can you please, might be, you know what?
Give me like one nasihah advice, yeah.
Yeah, Akhi. You don't have that. As soon as the prayer done, masjid's closed.
Yeah.
The youngsters, they ain't got nowhere to go to. And then we ended up chasing all the Lord just, Akhi, it's about time that we need to tackle
the masjid. Yeah, sure.
Tell them we need to open them hours. Want access for these youngsters.
Yeah.
That's what we need to do.
You're right. I agree with you. That's a good point. That's very good. That have extra hours. For those shabab, if you have a problem, come forward, speak to us. Yeah, it'll be very good. Even I'm going to do a video about it.
Yeah, we've got so many counselors, whatever.
Yeah.
They can volunteer 5-6 hours a week, come there, sit in the mosque.
Yeah.
Any problem that they can. I want to speak to the community themselves.
Yeah.
Discreetly.
Yeah.
I don't have to tell, you know what, my boy,
it
has to be anonymous because obviously, we men, we like to keep our things to ourselves.
Yeah, it's true.
We suppress things.
We suppress our things. I don't want to talk to my brother and tell him what the problem is. You know, Aki,
it's summarish, isn't it? They're really comfortable.
It's summarish, man. But we're like, Aki, we can tackle these things.
Yeah.
But step by step, we have to be the beacon to our community, Aki.
Yeah, it's true.
Mashallah, I can't lie, look, like, just the other day I was eating chicken and chips the other day, yeah? And behind me, I could hear this black brother speaking to his son. I could hear him lecturing his son. But he put his son aside and asked him, how are you doing in school? What's your grades like?
Yeah.
How's things? Have you been bullied? And I listened for like maybe half an hour. And I turned around, I sat down and joined them. I said to them, listen, I said to the young kid, you're so lucky you have a father that's paying attention to your life.
Yeah. Yeah? Yeah.
You're fortunate he's alive, because I don't have a father no more. Right? You know, and then at the same time, you have a father that's paying attention to your life. There's fathers that leave their kids to do whatever they want.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand? A mother can only raise her son or daughter to a degree.
But you need the father. Now, your son can be doing some dodgy stuff while he's inside the house.
And Instagram, and he won't know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Instagram, what they call it, Facebook, Snapchat. As Sheikh Fawzan mentioned, he said, now inside the house or inside his room, you have to check his phone. You don't have to make him like, you know, I'm going to make your life miserable. No, to make sure he's doing well. Who are you speaking to? Who are your friends? Take him for a walk and all of that. Because when I was young, my father used to take me for a walk. Yeah, yeah, I remember, there's one thing I learned from my father. I was walking with him, right, and I put my hands inside my pocket. He said, don't do that. Because why? Imagine you're a trip and you fall, and someone tries to attack you. So you have to be ready.
Yeah, yeah. Life lessons, not life lessons.
That takes a long time to learn it. Yeah. But I learned it in 1 second. Why? Because it's based upon experience.
Absolutely.
Understand?
Listen, we come from a generation where our fathers generally will take us around London to parks, show us a lot of life. Fathers right now, it's about, yo, let me buy my kids this, let me buy that. And I said, that's the only father you need to advise your kids, you need to be there for them. Yeah. You know, you need to.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, yeah. But it's a good point, okay, inshallah. We have to have the brothers in our community, our area. Yeah. Okay, that lifestyle is not good.
It's not good.
Wallahi, okay, even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that the friends, they will be enemy toward each other. Except who? Except the pious friends.
Yes.
Friends are, imagine you have a friend, he's always telling you, I would die for you, I would do this for you. But when you die, and he dies, because you both of you died upon misguidance, you start cursing each other.
You see? Why did I follow this guy?
Yes.
Why did I listen to this guy?
I wish I never followed this guy. Exactly. But you know, when Allah said, إِلَّا الْمُتَّقُونَ, except the pious ones. The one, for example, Liban, he said, Shamsi, come here, let's go for masjid, go pray. Ibn Qayyim mentioned, imagine I died before Liban. I said, oh Allah, the brother Liban used to call me to do rash actions. Keep him firm until he meets me. You see it? But if your friend is an evil man, he said, oh Allah, that guy, he misguided me. Oh Allah, keep him misguided. You see? So now, when you know there's no one more truthful in his speech than Allah, you step back, say, let me choose a friend wisely.
Exactly.
I want a friend that will make dua for me. Yes. No friends when I die, he go buy alcohol and start drinking it or dashing on my grave. Start smoking drugs. No, no. My friend who will raise my hand, he said, oh Allah, forgive Shamsi only bad. Understand? That's what a friend you need, akhi. Wallahi, akhi. That's what the friend. The messenger of Allah said, Al-Mafu ala deen khalileh. The friend upon the religion of his friend.
Exactly.
For the man.
Yeah, 100%. And that's what we need exactly with what we need. To be fair, in all circle around, obviously it's good to tell people about the deen,
yeah,
and let people work on it.
Yeah.
But our community ourselves, we've got duty to care for them. At the end of the day, our youngsters, our brothers, because they're the
without beacon. Without, yeah.
They're the one that's going to come next and take this further.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what you guys got up for. I think you guys should just...
No, okay, and what you said is, I agree with it. Yeah. Okay, it's a good thing. You know, even I will make a video about it, yeah, that if the Masjid al Sunnah, yeah, come, we have extra hours for you. Exactly. If you want to get rid of this life, I mean, live this life, yeah, whatever you need, come and advise us.
Of course,
you see what I'm saying? Because especially when they see, this brother Shamsi is young, yes, he's been in that lifestyle,
exactly,
so they can trust you more. Yeah. I'm going to come speak to him, he can give me some advice.
Exactly.
You know how hard it is, yeah? Do you know how hard it is to, for the average young Muslim to sit in an average khutbah these days,
yeah,
and they're learning things that either they basically, it's like basic information they know, yeah, or like, for example, Isa al-Masjid, they did a khutbah not too long ago,
yeah,
when they were talking about the gang problems in Tower Hamlets.
Yeah.
And then they were talking down upon these drug dealers, these young Muslim gangsters, but they're speaking so harsh towards them, but they're not understanding that these kids are from your community,
yeah,
they're your sons, they're your daughters at the end of the day. Like, yeah, because if I hit, look, Allah Shamsi, how many times have I sat in the khutbah and I've been bored? I'm not learning anything, and secondly, the way they're talking is like, oh, whatever, what are you doing for our community?
Yeah.
And how much masjids are so corrupt to the point where, like, certain people are benefiting from that masjid, you know, and the wider community doesn't benefit. These kids are like they're like wild, they're like, they're out there, they do what they want, they won't listen to anyone.
They
can only listen to someone that has lived their life and transitioned from that lifestyle.
That's true.
What can they really learn from a 50-year-old or 60-year-old man that talks down upon them, that doesn't really know about their generation?
I remember I was saying that to the brother, like, when there was one brother left Islam, okay, and his mother was like, let me take you to Imam. But what they don't understand, mainly the Imam is an old man coming from back home who doesn't know, even if he knows, he just memorizes the Quran. He's not really, he doesn't know things about the deen of Allah. So he said to his mom, I want to every Imam, they cannot answer my questions. Islam is only true. So his brother called me. He said, can you speak to him? I said, Akhi, the best person for this guy, and if he's Anwar. He's a man for it, mashallah. I said, Anwar spoke to him, he became back to Islam. Alhamdulillah, but Allah's permission. Because Anwar, mashallah, has to give the gap. He has to break it down. So the guy came back to Islam. Why? Anwar born here, he is mixed. Even our brother Abu Iyad, Abu Rafiq, same thing happened to him. Because these brothers are still of knowledge, old in age, but they mix with Shabab.
Exactly.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. So they get in contact with us, what's going on? So we get, because we need our old in age,
yes,
and experience.
Yeah.
They direct us, we seek advice from them, yeah, that's how we move.
Exactly.
Yeah? You understand, yeah, that's how we move, akhi.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, akhi.
You know, even it comes to even helping them come into the prayer, brother. As soon as they finish school, think about it. Parents, yeah, they don't have their kids.
So there's more time in the...
Yeah, from Asr till, you know, Maghrib or whatever. Yeah. In that between that gap while the mosque is closed, they lay things on top.
I've happened to ask before, you know.
I
used to go to a masjid before earlier. As soon as they finish the prayer, you have to leave.
Yeah, you have to.
Bro, as we can, I need someone speaking.
Yeah,
alhamdulillah, Majid, akhi, you know Majid.
Yeah.
Classes, we have classes every day. Even we have talks online,
exactly,
on our channel. So for Shabab, young brothers before them,
yeah,
let us speak to them, address them. We do the alhamdulillah. But it's true, some mosques, akhi, just old people.
Yes.
Leave. Don't do this, don't do that.
Yeah.
Bro, this Shabab, our time, as the Sheikh Salah, Sheikh Qudan, is a Shabab of internet.
Yeah.
Shut up Instagram, shut up off Snapchat.
Yeah.
So you have to be updated as well.
Yeah.
Come bring mentality of back home 50 years ago, just address a young boy,
exactly,
who is in Britain.
It does not make no sense.
I think our generation and the younger generation, I think they're going through more problems than the elder generation. Look how much things that we're exposed to.
Yeah.
Just through your phone, you're exposed to anything and everything, and it's crazy. There's some of the young kids that I speak to, when they check up on me, when I check up on them, you know, one of the last things I say to them, even before I say salam alaikum, stay alive. Let us see kids stay alive, you know? Like, a lot of these kids, they tell me, they're scared that when they go home, when they leave the house, am I coming back home? Some of them have to carry something, not because they want to hurt anybody, to defend themselves.
Yes.
I can't blame them.
Correct.
I really can't blame them. And it's sad.
Yeah.
It's so sad. Look, my generation was violent. I think it's even more violent now.
The hadith in it, some said, every generation gets worse.
It's worse.
Yeah, every century generation. But you know, but what this teach us, okay, for our brothers out there, sisters, sticking with deen. What I know is, okay, world man, if you still practicing, they respect you. I know it's that. Wallahi, many times I'm walking through something, Shabab, okay, and I say, you stop doing that, don't touch him. He's also, okay, so,
yeah.
You know
the respect they have.
They have respect. So that shows you what, they still have hair in them.
There was
two sisters there, Muslim sisters, don't mention their country, they were shouting. It's a miskin, a no guy, no more guy, because I'm wearing khamis. So it's brother.
Yeah.
That is a sign what? They have goodness.
Of course.
So you can, mashallah, you have goodness.
Yeah.
So you know what? You can support them, mashallah, look at you.
Yeah.
Understand?
Yeah.
Like you said, everything just bang them down.
Yeah.
You're nothing,
yeah.
You wasn't a donkey.
Because that kills their confidence and their brain.
Yeah.
And it makes them play on their man, the Shaitan plays on their man, like, you know what, you already come this far,
yeah,
you're already this bad, you might as well carry on going.
Yeah.
There's no hope.
It's like the story of the man who killed the 99
person. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He came to jail, he said to him, you know, is there any terror for me? He said, no.
He killed him.
Because he made him despair for Allah's mercy.
Yeah,
it's very sad, akhi. Go on, further.
We also need to tap into the professionals, like I said, you know, the doctors, lawyers, whatever. Our mothers, our sisters, you know, they can barely speak English there and there and whatnot.
Yeah.
If they have those hour and a half, even within the mosque itself, a female professional,
yeah,
goes out and volunteers an hour a day or hour a week and tells them about the law, where they stand, you know, in terms of health, women. Maybe, you know, a young girl.
Yeah.
You know what, the one that's got, you know, good bits in her heart, the one that, yeah, you know, heard you wearing a khamis.
Yeah.
For example,